Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, version 4.5.1 came out, and there have been some massive updates to the macro toolbar. We're going to take a general overlook at all the new added features, and dive into a couple of them and show you what they do. Let's dive into the DAW and check it out. Version 4.5 just came out, and there's been some massive updates to the macro toolbar. Right here is the button to turn on your macro toolbar if you don't already have it on. You may see it like this. If it's blue and active, you're taking a look at your macro toolbar. Right now we're looking at the global page, and we can verify that by looking in this corner. There's already been some added features to just the global page alone. Underneath action is pretty much everything you can do inside Studio One. Things like turning off all of your effects, doing some legato and overlaps, quantizing to the quarter note, thinning your MIDI out some more. Then also there's some submenus in here too, like align, editing, the list goes on and on. Almost every function inside Studio One is available in this submenu. Next to that, we have the name dropdown. And what this is gonna do, if I grab my bass guitar here, what I can do is drop down name, find bass, and say electric bass. And then you'll see that right here, it changed it to electric bass. I'm gonna undo, and you'll watch it go back to the file name. This may be good for when you're doing some exports for someone else to mix, or when you're done writing your song and you wanna make sure that your bounce is exactly what you think it is, then you can do this and name your file, bounce your files, and it'll hold this name over. Going further into the global toolbar, we see things that we've seen before, like merge, our splits, the zooms, the audio effects here, like adding or subtracting 3 dB of clip gain. We can also render our event effects right here. Then we see some of the MIDI musical macros that we've seen before. And then there's this area over here, which actually is a relatively new area. Again, here's that all effects off button, the song folder button, which will actually bring you into either File Explorer on PC or Finder on Mac and show you the actual folder that this song file is in. It gets good if you have a lot of sessions going on and you want to make sure that your file structure is proper. Then here's the button to bring you to the new plugin manager. And we'll do a different video on this another time. Let's take a look at some of the newly added pages inside macros. Over here next to global, you'll see it's got a drop-down option. And here we can see the entire menu of some of the newly added macros. Musical edit, audio editing, music creation, and explore macros. This is actually how you get around and faster ways to navigate inside your session. We can show the entire session, or we can zoom into just our loop selection, which is really handy when you're trying to work on a specific part of a song. Some extra buttons that I also like in this menu are over here in the Add Effects. If you click on EQ or Comp, it will throw the Pro EQ or the stock compressor at the end of your signal chain on the channel you have selected. I have my bass here. If I hit Compressor, it adds another compressor to the end of my chain. And I may have tested this out a few times before. Let's take a look at some other macro pages. Let's go to music creation. This page is really good for our writers who are using a lot of MIDI, and that can be composing for film or anything like that, or actually just beefing up your music production. This section has a lot of familiar things that we've seen already, like moving up or down an octave, but also has some new features too, like the mirror selections. If I grab just a section of notes and mirror horizontally, you'll see that the pattern changed on the front and the back. We'll change it again, and it's back to the way I had it originally. On this end over here, you have the thin out section, where you can actually grab a selection of notes and reduce how many notes are actually in that selection. Each time you click, it'll take 25% of the notes out. Let's change to another macro page and go to music editing. You'll see a lot of our very similar MIDI macros right up here. And you also have the ability to transpose and alter the pitch. We'll change to another page and go to audio editing. We've seen some of these before, like adding 5 layers or bouncing our selection. The adding or subtracting 3 dB of clip gain is also here. And some of our macros will be doubled up depending on which menu you're in. Let's go ahead and grab that bass guitar and we'll zoom in. As expected, we can increase the clip gain by 3 dB with each click or minus 3 dB with this button here. Here's the macro to normalize the audio and set the peaks to minus 12. Let's see this in action. It's that fast. If you had a longer clip, it might take a little longer, and it also depends on your machine. Here's something really crazy. At the end here, under transients, we have align transients. For those users who came from Pro Tools, you're probably used to Beat Detective. This almost replaces Beat Detective. If we hit this with our bass guitar, you see it process. It went in, found our transients, clipped the notes, moved them to the grid, and then applied a crossfade and bounced the selection, all with one click. You'll have to go in, just like you did with Beat Detective, and make sure it didn't miss any notes or maybe double something up or cause some weird artifacts. It's really great to have this. And let's go to our last menu, Musical Edit. You'll see some more of our standard MIDI macros in here, things like adding or subtracting velocity to notes, humanizing, muting, putting the chords up and down, doing your quantize, more legato and note length things over here. And this section over here, allowing you to select different notes based on your criteria. Maybe you want all the quarter notes. You can select this one. Maybe you want all the eighth notes, so on and so forth. There's a lot of brand new things that came out with the macros inside of Studio One with version 4.5. Version 4.5 is a free upgrade for everybody who already had version 4. There's way too much to talk about in this video alone. So if there's a certain function that you saw in here and you'd have a question about it, ask it in a comment and I'll answer that in a future video. Here's the great thing before we wrap up this video. All of these functions are assignable to a keyboard shortcut. You can go in and find your macros. And now you can see so many more options are within the macros. And these are all standard with version 4.5, plus all of the macros that you've made yourself. Everything is assignable to its own custom keyboard shortcut, speeding up your workflow. I wish I could dive in more and talk to you about every single function, but there's way too many to handle. That's all for now. If you found this video informative, please like and share the video. For more, visit timflansbaum.com, and if you have a question, ask it in a comment, and I'll answer it in a future video. Thanks for watching.